Thank you. Tamarun Hatun, Serena, I am returned.
Ah, you found each other.
Ours is the soil, Hien. The Domans, and the Eorzeans, too.
You know us?
The gods know you, child. As do the stars in the heavens, which shone bright at your coming.
The Mole hearken to the whispers of the Elder Gods, which guide us in our daily lives. We know them through the Utun, like my grandmother.
Hatun, I am come to beg a boon of you and yours. That I might liberate my homeland, I seek to rally the strength of the steppe. To that end, I wish to fight in the Nardom. As a warrior of the Maw, will you grant me this honor?
To stand with the Maw is fruitless. Hien, do not do this. The gods may have willed that our tribe join in the Nardom, but... there is no path to victory. We are weak and our numbers few. Even with your help, it would be impossible.
I thank you for your concern, Serena. But it is precisely because of the seeming hopelessness of your cause that we must needs cast our lot with you. Were we to join hands with a more favored tribe, our victory would inevitably be attributed to them, and no one would follow me to Doma.
T'was the gods' will that we fight. Mayhap this too is their design. Hear me then. As Hatun of the Mole, I invite you all to join with us in the Nardom. Will you look after them?
Come with me, friends. There is much I would show you.
You... wait. I would have words. A singular radiance. Shimmering. Like a jewel of the Dusk Mother, blinding in its brilliance. Stars flicker and flock to you. Before such gathered light, even the secrets of the gods may be laid bare. Some are fated to rise in grace and glory, others to falter and fade, though not from memory. Both will be your strength and salvation come the end. Cherish the stars and the light they bring you in the dark. For you are a traveler, are you not?
She needed the rest. To come so far and carry so much. Hien and his friend, too. Strange that they should vanish so soon.
Not troubled by your old wounds, I see.
Nor you by yours. I know I should have fled with the others after father died, instead of blindly fighting on. It was reckless and foolish, and there was naught to be gained from it. Everything to lose, rather.
We know no path save the one we walk. I myself am in no hurry to meet those who have gone before. Not while I have still to make amends.
Well said.
You are none the worse for your time in the wilderness. On the contrary, I would say you have improved.
Come now, your victories still far exceed mine. Or have you forgotten all the times you trounced me as a boy?
I feared I would not see you again.
A life so fortuitously saved should be spent wisely. Without regret, would I have traded it for our people's amnesty, had it been their will. Instead, they have called for the sword, and so that is what I must be. Until this blade is broken, I can but carve a path forward. Were you truly so concerned for my well-being? You never showed it when we used to spar.
How you cried when you lost, and when your mother tried to comfort you. And when you inevitably came at me once more, swinging your wooden sword wildly. Rina's little Master Shun. What a fine young man you've become.
A man should not be addressed by his childhood name. I've told you about that before. Ah, the mask slips. And I was so close to cultivating a winning persona.
There will be opportunity enough for putting on airs after you have returned in triumph to Doma. Now is the time to show our true character.
Yes, yes. Tis a name my parents gave me as a child, but I should like to think I have long since outgrown it. But as you seem determined to bring it back into use, I believe a match is in order. If I win, you will be honor-bound to divulge one of your darkest secrets.